There was a Yid called the Yehuda HaChassid. Yehuda HaChassid was one of the Rishonim. Mm-hmm. He was early Rishonim, was called a Chassid because he was a real Chassid. And he's very medactic and everything. And he wrote a Sefer, he has two Svarim, Sefer Chassidim. And he has a Sefer called, there's a Sefer which is called Tzavas of Yehuda HaChassid. His Tzavas, his will, which is basically different things which he instructed the people should do or shouldn't do. And he doesn't explain the reasons for why you should do these things, but he explains what would happen if someone wouldn't listen to these different things, then chas v'shalom, certain bad things would happen to the person. And a lot of the achrayim try to understand as to why he said these things, what was the reason for it, what's the problem, and how can we go about avoiding it if someone comes to certain situations.
Whether it still applies also, right?
There's like, just to throw out a few things, there's about
not
breaking an oven. You're not supposed to break an oven, destroy an oven. You're not supposed to fully close up a door, a doorway. Shouldn't fully close up a doorway. There is not marrying two brothers, two sisters, or a sister and a brother,
And not to leave
same
the same
family.
Town.
No, that he didn't say. That's the way how we get out of it.
He
didn't say that. He said if siblings marry into each other, two brothers, or a brother marries a sister and a sister marries a brother, chas v'shalom is a sakana for their lives. We have different ways, different poiskim, different rabbanim, rebbes, of different ways how we deal with these sava, how we deal with the sava, because he didn't write the reasons. So we don't know how far this goes. There's another example. He says you're not allowed to make a bathhouse in your house. So, well, the example, the Rebbe Marash, we one time learned here, last year, the Rebbe Marash wrote a whole tshuva about how to be matter to build a bathhouse, a mikveh in a house. People want to make a private mikveh in a home. It's an issue. How about people having nowadays, we have bathtubs in our house, how do we deal with it? But a lot of things which is not clear the reasons for why he said these things. So different poskim brought up different reasons and different type of a tale. Tonight what we want to discuss, we're going to get a little bit general idea of how the poskim go about dealing with the different savois which come up all the time.
When did this person...
And was one of the great Rishonim, the medieval scholars. He was a very big chassid and big Ruach HaKodesh and Nevuah. His father also, Reb Shmuel HaChassid. A very unique period in history, the big tzaddikim. Tonight, we're going to focus on one of the things that he writes, one of his tzavois, what we call. One of his tzavois, written in his tzava, in this sort of this will, where different instructions, one of the instructions is, someone should not marry a woman whose father's name is the same as his name. Meaning the son-in-law and father-in-law share the same name, they should not marry into each other.
As long as you're not Syrian.
Now...
They name their sons after them.
Yeah.
Can I ask a question? When you said the door, it's also a window.
Right.
Any opening that's closed. So can I ask a question? Because, for 20 years I've been meaning to do it in my house because the people before us covered up a window.
Yeah.
And I've been meaning to... right now, it's the first time in 20 years I've been trying to remember to ask a chef. Do I have to do it?
Better than
there's second. Ways how to deal with it. You have to find.
I know you put like a little hole, right?
Yeah, there's different ways how you deal with it. You have to speak to ask her up.
You know, I was building a mikveh in my house, and my mother, her own mother married, and her husband, my mother's parents, and have a brother and sister that also married brother and sister. She stopped me from doing the mikveh in my house. She was nervous.
But it's the same issue. So Maisa. So there's one issue about son-in-law marrying a father-in-law, same name. Also about a daughter-in-law and a mother-in-law having the same name. So since this week's parasha is Parasha Shmois, talk about names. Elo Shmois, Bnei Yisrael, Aboy Mitzrayim. These are the names of the Yidden that came to Mitzrayim. We go through the list. The Torah actually says, this is Reuven and Shimon. They came to Mitzrayim, Reuven and Shimon. And they left Mitzrayim as Reuben and Shimon. They kept their Jewish names, even though in Mitzrayim they had a lot of challenges. and a lot of, and the Yidden went down to very low levels in certain aspects, but some things they kept very strong, and being unique and separate as a culture and having their own names was something that was very strongly kept. They came as Reuben and Shimon, and they left as Reuben and Shimon. So therefore, I thought we'd talk a little bit about names, about this connection with the names, the in marriage, mother-in-law, father-in-law. But we're going to get a little background how the Poiskim view this special tzavois of Rabbi Yehuda HaChassid, these instructions. How do we deal with these instructions? So we're going to start off by reading one of the biggest Poiskim, the Noideh B'Yehuda. The Noideh, we're going to see a tzavah of his. This is the question. It was a question, someone wrote him like this. L'kvoid ahuvi talmidi yedidi erva mucham v'nein arav David. He's writing to his Talmud of David. Halayla azeik yani mechtavcha. Tonight your letter to me arrived. Asher ata shoyel v'dvar ha-shidduch ha-madubar. You're asking about a shidduch. L'ischoscha for your brother-in-law, who's a ben, im ben Torah, v'yis sister-in-law. Gisasa, your sister-in-law, with a ben Torah v'yasam. With a bacher who's a Torah, dika bacher, ben Torah, he learns Torah. Yachs and he has a good yichus. Only this is the issue. Actually, b'shas chol yoy, when he wasn't feeling well, they changed his names. When so, a lot of times, if someone is not feeling well, add a name.
Yeah, they didn't add. They changed the name. They add a name.
They added a name. Who kishem avipsol? The added name that they added, the Shini Hashem, the name they added was the same name as the name of the his sister-in-law, the father of his sister-in-law.
In other words, his name before was
his father-in-law.
Then he became Rafael.
Basically, the Chassin's name, the Bacher they're interested in, his name that they changed to, let's say changed it to Rafael. Now that name, the father-in-law has the same name. Should they go with the shidduch or not? So he writes him like this. He has one of the very interesting things in the Tzavah of Yehuda HaChassid. A lot of fascinating things in this Tzavah of Yehuda HaChassid. One of them is, he says you should not marry your niece.
Niece?
You should not marry your niece.
Wow.
Now in the Gemara, Chazal, we find in Chazal that when the pasuk says "Mipsor chal tesalim," do not hide yourself from your family, meaning you have to help your family. Means your niece needs a shidduch. You should marry her, help her out, marry her. She's your niece. It's a mitzvah. Not only is it something not negative, it's a mitzvah. That's one of the things the Chazal say. However, Rabbi Yehuda HaChassid writes in his Tzava that someone who marries their niece, it's a big sakana. And he doesn't explain why. And this actually seemingly negates a clear Gemara. And it's clearly mutter api Torah. The Torah is mati you to marry your niece. However, the Torah mati you to marry your niece, but not only that, Chazal say not only is it mutter, it's a mitzvah. And comes Rabbi Yehuda HaChassid and says, don't you dare marry your niece. This is a big sakana for you. What's going on over here? So this is Rabbi Yehuda HaChassid is going to answer his Talmud regarding marrying his sister or marrying someone who has the same name as her father after they made the name change, after he wasn't feeling well, which is another one of Tzavos Rabbi Yehuda HaChassid. He's going to answer to start this in general discussing how we deal with the instructions of Rabbi Yehuda HaChassid. Ahu vi Talmidi.
Can I ask a question first?
Yeah.
When in the Torah you have a choik, we don't know the reason. It's a choik, right? So how?
That's fine. It's a choik, but over here he's challenging ideas in the Torah.
No, but he's not giving an explanation.
No explanations.
So that he has in essence is giving a choik from himself, like as if he's.
But how could he do that? We're going to see what Yehuda's going to ask.
You're reinforcing the question.
Reinforcing that he's not giving a reason. He's not a Shem.
That question. No question asked.
Who is he dad?
Not only that, why did the Arizal or anyone else come up with these things?
Who is he dad?
Well, the Arizal was later.
Who was he to ask?
Grilled tuna.
The Talmud was asking him. So says, answers the Lady Yehuda. Ahuvi Talmidi. My beloved one, my Talmud. Luli avoscha, if not for my love for you, in darki lahoshi biyonim keilu. He answered very sharply. I don't answer such type of tshuvas. You're asking me to discuss something, to write a tshuva, a responsa, on an issue which is not mentioned in the Gemara of the Poiskim. You want to ask me about that, an issue that's not mentioned in any Gemara or Poiskim. It's just a Tavar of Yehuda Chassid. That's not what I do. I answer Gemara and Poiskim. I'm a Rav. Ach, goyda avoscha. But your great Ava, to me, it's the eini chutzigidi. I'm going beyond what I normally do. And I'm going to answer you. Da, you should know, Talmidi Achav, my beloved Talmid, v'yu dvarim alolu chakukim aluach libechel izakarit. These words should always be engraved in your heart for memory. Haklal agodol, a great rule. She'ein l'chol chachomim she'achar talmud l'shos le'merdover neged talmud. No chacham, no matter how wise they are, after the Gemara, has any permission to speak against the Gemara. No one can challenge what it says in the Gemara. Va'oymer dover lister kuti shliyum medivar talmud. Any chacham who says something to contradict, even a little point of what the Gemara says. Lo yichosh b'chachat misal. We do not consider him from Chachmi Yisrael. It goes against the Gemara. Amnon, however, k'she'ono moitzim. What happens when we find echem chachmi Yisrael? We find someone who is a Chacham Yisrael. He's one of our Chachamim. Hamuchzik b'toyer b'yirli safek. Without a doubt, he's someone who's a Yira Shemayim, he's God-fearing, and he knows the stuff. He knows Torah. We find such a Chacham. Shekasev b'sefer, he writes in his Sefer something. Dover has soyis of divatam, which seems to contradict the Gemara. In such a case, we're not going to just disregard him at all, because if we don't know who he is, you're saying something against the Gemara, you're not one of our Chachamim. But if it's someone who we respect, and he is mochsik by us, as someone as he's one of Chachmi Yisrael, and he says something which looks like it's a contradiction to our Gemara, so then chayav model mashkuni nafshin letarizva. We have to push ourselves to answer his words and to try to understand it shouldn't be a contradiction because he wouldn't go against the Gemara.
Was Yehuda Chassid also a known Talmudist? Was he one of the Balei Tosfos?
We don't have from Svarim a Balei Tosfos.
Nobody.
We know he's Chachmi, so even he didn't write in Gemara.
Who said?
He didn't write in Gemara. No, he was accepted by everyone. He's mentioned.
And he was a Chassid, but who said he was a Goy?
I think there's even a Rashi somewhere who brings from his father something. No, he was. That's not defining Chachmi Yisrael. He was sure was Chachmi Yisrael to every. The child, if he wrote in this area, he was sure one of the Chachmi Yisrael. He was a big tzaddik. He was a big Chassid. Everyone recognized if you heard that.
It's a Balei Tosfos. Whatever.
Yeah, it was from that tkufa, yeah. We don't have any specific svarim from in this series. So we have to say, that chacham, whoever that chacham is, shleidibar rak l'sha, will say that person said something which seems to be against the Gemara, it was only temporarily, for some reason. Oilu mishpacha is for a certain family, specific family. However, the words of the Gemara are to all of Klal Yisrael. That Chacham was a personal, private instruction for some reason, for that time. However, in all times in history, and for all people, we're obligated to follow whatever it says in the Talmud and the Gemara. But Kayoitza Bazeh, a similar idea to what I'm telling you, we find by Rabbi Yehuda HaChassid. Till now he didn't mention Rabbi Yehuda HaChassid. On the Moitzel Abeinu Yehuda HaChassid B'tzavah Shaloi, we find his savod dvarim certain things. Shekimat, it's almost also in l'shem. It's forbidden to even hear them.
Wow.
For example, Ki Oimer, he says shalayisa basafoyis. A person shouldn't marry the daughter of his sister, his niece. However, there's a clear Gemara Yevamis Amru Shemitzah. It's a mitzvah. Something else. Another problem.
Can I say maybe this Who is Oimer, like Rabbeinu Chananel, like the Chayram of Rabbeinu Chananel.
He said that it's
a great Gesh, right. He said that you're not allowed to do certain things. So just, why should, even though it's a Mutter Pitoy, you'd have two wives, but he said he stopped it.
Well, Emma says some people are going to amaz with that way. He doesn't go with that mahala. Some people amaz with that way. Now, but you have to see why they did it. Another thing. Who Oimer? Rabbeinu Yehuda HaChassid says.
Rabbeinu Gershon gave a reason.
Shalayisa Av Upanoi Shtei Achoyis. A father and a son shouldn't marry two sisters. That's what he says. However, an argument we have that a papa and his son, they married the two daughters of Abba Surah. They did do that. Another thing. Who Aimer, Yehuda Chassid says, Shleyisu Beis Achim Shtei Achoyis, two brothers shouldn't marry two sisters. However, we have a Gemara, and Shmoinim Zug Achim Koyanim. There were 80 brothers, Koyanim, came from different wives. Nosu Shmoinim Zug Achoyis Koyanis. They married to 80 sisters Koyanis. So there was not an issue. They did 80 to 80.
Maybe Kohanim, yes, but not regular person.
Okay. Furthermore, today, Benasid Rav Chista, there were two daughters of Rav Chista, the Gemara says, Haben Esiva were married to
two brothers,
Rami, Omar, Okfer, Achami. The Chayoyitze Bezevet Savari. We have many of the like this, these issues in this Savar Rabbi Yehuda Chassid. So now we're going back. We know Rabbi Yehuda Chassid was from Chachmi Yisrael. We know he was a big Yerushimayim and a big Gadol B'Torah. There's nothing to question about. However, we are finding certain things which he said, which seem to totally contradict our Gemara. So how are we going to reconcile this? So he gave his rule earlier that he told this Talmud. Remember, no one can go against the Gemara. You find someone vote against the Gemara in general, he's not one of the Chachamim. But if we know he's a Chacham and we see him suddenly going against the Gemara, we'll say it's a private thing, just for his family, it's a special instruction. It's not the regular instruction. So he says like this, Imhayach, last two lines of the right column. Imhayach chassid mitzavet tzavazu l'chol Yisrael. If the chassid, that's how he was termed, if you heard the chassid, the pious one, was if he commanded this instruction to all of Klal Yisrael, then, had he was sorry to the Talmud, he's contradicting the Talmud, the Gemara. But you also l'anul l'kabal d'ar klal, be forbidden for us to accept his words at all. Top of the second column. Aval, however, Ha'emes Yoyre Darki, the truth will show its path. Yeah, Chassid, the Chassid never meant to instruct all of Klal Yisrael in these instructions that he wrote. He wrote it Lazare Achrav Tzibel Adoyrodoyrus. He commanded only for his ancestors, for his seed, his grandchildren until the ending of time should follow his personal private tzava, his personal will and testament. Kirahi, for he saw Baruch HaKodesh, with his divine inspiration, that his seed, his ancestors, won't succeed with these type of marriages. So he saw what others don't see.
Oh, maybe people.
And he saw this is not for his family. This is not good. It's a special thing for his family, for his neshama, for his children, for his einikach to all generations. It was a private, personal tzavah. This is not meant for Klal Yisrael.
Could it be also the reason? But
Zayin is so yisur divrei Talmud. In this way, this answer will not contradict the Gemara, because the Gemara never meant Shua Klal. It's all of Klal Yisrael. The divrei HaChassid Hu Al Prat. It's for the specific individual, his family. Ha-chad, that is one answer I'm going to give you.
Can I say something?
He's going to go on to give other answers in the specific case of this person. So the first answer he's giving is, the whole Tzava Sabid HaChassid, very possibly, was only meant for his family. It's only meant for Zarei. You're not a family. You're asking me a question about an issue about a mother, a son, and a son-in-law and a father having the same name. Fine, that was for his family. You're not a grandchild of Yehuda HaChassid, so it's fine for you. That's one answer. Then I give a bunch of more.
The Tosfos Yom Tov lived about 600 years ago?
Closer.
Yeah, but in the mid-1400s. He was a Talmud of the Maharal.
Yeah.
So there's thousands of Yidden today that know they're descendants of his.
People know they're descendants of Yehuda HaChassid also today.
Oh, so what I was going to say is, though, maybe a lot of people kept it because it could be that because Ashkenazi Jewry Bechlal only descended, they say, from a few hundred Mishpachas. So maybe because you don't know if you're a Chassid.
We'll see. Some say. You'll see. Okay. Ein there is a tshuva of another Gadol B'Yisrael from a similar period of time, the Shev Yaakov. A little bit later, the Shev Yaakov writes that he talked about a similar situation like this, where they weren't married yet, but it was a shidduch made, and it turned out that the mother, the daughter-in-law, and the mother-in-law are going to have the same name. The future daughter-in-law and mother-in-law are going to have the same name. Now this family wanted to, the daughter, the girl wanted to break off the shidduch. She heard different things about the chassan, heard he has this problem or that, and then the father's not going to really, pay, he's not going to give a dowry, and then all these different things they found out. So they want to break off the shidduch. But there was a lot of money spent already, you know, to make the shidduch happen, and there was presents given, there was a lot of different, there was questions coming up. So they wrote to the Shev Yankov Ashayla. And one of the issues in the middle was that he never knew about Rabbi Yehuda Chassid Savor, and now he heard that this is an issue. So this puts into the baggage that we should marry into the family because the mother-in-law is going to have the same name as my daughter. So he wants to break out of the whole thing. So the Shev Yankov deals with all the issues in this whole breaking up of the shidduch. If they have to pay a knas or not.
They just don't change the name. Add a name. Like the Rebbe says.
So he said that one of the things he says is that it's doubtful, it's very possibly that he wrote this for Zare.
Right.
But even if it's, and even if it's not for sure, we're not sure, it's not clear if it's only written for his Zare now, maybe it's for the whole Klal Yisrael. He says, the Shev Yankov said like this, once they already made the shidduch, it's like b'diavad. They already got engaged.
Right.
It's b'diavad already. So therefore, he says, in such a case, since we don't know for sure, maybe it's only for Zari. We don't know for sure, but maybe he only wrote it for his Zara, for his family.
Fake.
So therefore, ain't safek moitzei vade.
Two fakes.
So he didn't want to. So he says, and besides, when he writes, we saw many rabbanim and gedolim that were not choishish for it. But he didn't want. So I'm just bringing up that even if it's a safek, it could be a reason for leniency. Not necessarily, even then, it's used as a leniency.
Yeah.
Let's go further.
He was the big Talmid Chacham, right? Rabbi Yehuda Hanasi. So why in the beginning of the
Tzavah?
Yehuda Chassid. You write down beginning of Tzavah, all forever you see I wrote here, it's for my family only. And no suffix, no problem. Why didn't
you
do that?
Listen, you can ask about everything. You know, why didn't the Mishnah make itself clear? We wouldn't need the Gemara to explain. Why did the Torah Shebiksav write everything clear, then there were no Torah Shabbat. Why did the Rashi not make it clear? We have to have so many Sfarim to understand Rashi. This is Torah. When the person said it, it was clear. When the person said it, it was clear. Later generations, we don't remember, we don't know, we have to figure it out. You know? Besides, by the way, he didn't actually write down the instructions. The instructions themselves were written down by Talmidim and other people. He didn't write it with actual Ksav Yad. It was passed down. Now, that was one issue, by the way. This answer that he gave, that the Tava, Yehuda Chassid, only applies to Zare, helps us for dealing with all the instructions of Yehuda Chassid said. However, this is not for sure. We don't know for sure this is the answer. This is one of the possibilities. One of the possibilities.
No, you want the paper.
Oh.
Page.
Ichabash action. Okay. So the Maisa, however, now the Behud is going to go on to say another 2 points to explain how this specific instruction does not apply, even if we say that this answer of Zari is not good, and reality is for all of Klal Yisrael for some reason. However, in your case, since the name was not your original name, not the original name of the chassan, it was the chassan's added name because he wasn't feeling well. They made a Shini Hashem, they added a name, and that added name is the one which is similar to the future father-in-law. It's different. It's different, and there, the tzavas of the chassan will not apply in this situation. This is this specific situation.
Is he going to explain why it doesn't apply?
Right now, he explains it. The fourth line, in the middle of the fourth line in the left column. I'll say further. Even not for this answer that I gave you about Zarei, regarding this specific question you asked me, there's no concern at all. Even if you were actually part of the family of Rabbi Yehuda Chassid. I will now give 2 reasons to prove the Ichiyach Shachos Diverak Al Ikeshem Etzem Anit Shasa Leide Shasa Mila Avoloi Al Shem Shin Is Barach Shin Hashem. The Tzavah Yehuda Chasid was not meant for an added name later on because someone wasn't feeling well. It was only meant for the name which was there at birth, by the birth, for the girl, or by the Mila, for the boy. Not for the name that was added, because the name that was added was similar to the father-in-law. Chada wants one reason. We have Chazal tell us that Zugais, the number two, even numbers, are not good, they're not healthy. There's something superstitious with even numbers. Zugais is called. Couples, pairs. Amru Psachim, the Gemara says Psachim, however, Koisha Bracha, you can have two Koisha Brachas, one after another. A Koisha Bracha, like Havdalah and Bechas Amazin. Yeah, Bechas Amazin. Mitztarev was not an issue by Koisha Bracha. Because Latoyiv and Mitztarev Shkoyach, Lorayin and Mitztarev. A Koisha Bracha, even though the second one is now, it's a second cup. So the Chora have now even numbers. So Zugis. So the Gemara, no. Since it's a Koishal Bracha, you make a Bracha on it, it's only Mitztarif for Toiv. The Toiv of Mitztarif, it can only bring good, adding it. And it can't affect anything evil. So the fact that it's a Bracha, it's a Koishal Bracha, wards off any possible effects of the even numbers bringing out, the Zugis, because it's a Koishal Bracha. The Toiv of Mitztarif, the Lorani Mitztarif. Because based on this Gemara, I'm going to apply the same example to our situation. Hashem Ezeshen is Baruch Boy, this name that he was blessed with by the Torah, this name that was added to him to heal him and make him feel better, was given to Lebracha Nitin. It was given to him to give him Bracha.
So what was the first one?
That was one he was born with.
But it was given him for a Bracha. What for? Nothing.
Good, but it wasn't Dafke with that Kavana. It was to be his name. This one was specifically given with a kavana to heal him and make him better. And we did a special thing, a special bracha. The first one, that was his name.
But usually you give it after a tzaddik, so he should be a bracha.
Good, but over here, the issue is a second name. The first name is not the issue. The issue is a second name. So we're discussing the second name. The second name was in this baruch by the bracha, Nitin. Well, the bracha mitztarif. Since it was for a bracha, it only could bring bracha. So you can't tell me, just because he has an added name, that name's going to bring him all the problems. How can that name bring him problems? That name was put there for brachas. Shemhoyim is damale isha. Asher shem avia k'shem ha'etzav shaloi. Both directions it could help you. What happens if this person, your sister-in-law, would find a bacher whose first name... Not the name that he was changed. Imagine the name, well, not the name that he was, that was the second name was similar to the father-in-law. What happened is his original first name, his birth name, was same as the father-in-law. It would also help for that. If you find a woman who the name of her father is like his actual name, you're about to take her. Why? Because he got a new name. Once he got a new name, Shem Shinizbarich, Mitztarif Latoy, Yesha Shem Chadash, he used that you have a new name. The new name brought with it Bracha. So it brought with you Bracha. So it only gives you Bracha.
Also, isn't it Shver? Most of the time, when they add an extra name because of a
Chayvi,
they don't take away the original name.
They add a name.
So, how is that going to be the same as a Shver?
What happens if the second name could be the same name?
Yeah, but it's only where both names are the same. If someone's name is Chaim Yankel, and the Shver's name is Yankel...
That's what you're coming up with a premise that Nebi Yehuda never learned.
No, I'm asking. He's saying
he never that. Learned that way. But Nebi Yehuda
why
never
is he learning
that?
He's only he getting one whole that. Name. When did they erase... I mean, this man is Zed, they don't erase the original name, they just add a name.
That was the same thing here.
So now this new name has the exact same as...
Yeah.
The, oh.
Yeah. And that's a problem. According to Yehuda, didn't see a way out of that. And Yehuda didn't have a way out from that.
So this is the way out because it was given for a bracha.
Yeah. Abel mizdamalei isha shashem avia kashem achodesh shloi. If he finds a wife who the name of her father is like his new name, ashames and shenita lebracha and mizdalef fara. V'yachol akarti kateker v'le yazik l'shem zachodesh. His new name is not going to damage him. L'brachanit l'shem zavalei l'klol. That's one shot. that even if you're from the Zera of Rabbi Yehuda HaChassid, it's not going to affect you.
So why don't you say the same thing about the niece? When he takes his niece, he's helping her out because she wants to be rather be with someone she knows. She feels more protected by her uncle.
Stay in the family.
Yeah.
By the way, Rabbi Yehuda HaChassid, this tshuva, is not dealing with all the tzavois. He's mainly zeroing in on the specific shaila he had.
Right.
But what he started off giving a hakdama was that one of the first things you could add in is say it was only made for Zarei, which automatically will help us with all his tzavois.
Right.
But he's not going with that only. That's not enough because it doesn't say that clearly that all of them are for Zarei. Happens to be there are a few of them which actually say on it next to it that it's only for his seat. The one who wrote down the Talmud that wrote it down wrote it only for his seat. But Rabbi Yehuda seemed to imply that maybe we could learn that all of them are for a Zera. But it's not for sure. So Rabbi Yehuda is adding other ideas, but they're only specific to this situation, the case of the names. Regarding the niece, you have to deal with it differently. Now, another issue. Vo'id Amina. Another point I'll say. Mistabro shekavona sahasid loy hoye al shem amischadish. For sure, the chassid never meant the new name. That new name is problematic. Only the original name. He brings an example from Yevamos. I don't remember the Gemara over there. But he says, four lines down, the line starts with Dalet Hei, Dira Maschel. Me'ata ni oimer, middle of the line. Me'ata ni oimer, kayoitze b'zeh. Now I'm going to say the same thing. Shabbat Tavos ha-chassid. What happens? What happens if they actually get married? A man and a woman got married. There's no issue with a name issue. They got married. There's no problems. The father-in-law and the son-in-law have different names. The mother-in-law and the daughter-in-law have different names. But lamacher yechla. Later on, he's gonna never get sick. The son-in-law. Vishtana shmei. His name is gonna be changed to Shem Chamiv. His father-in-law's name. What should he do? You got to. He should divorce his wife now. Or yachush kalyan sakana. He should be considering his whole life for sakana. It doesn't make sense. Ain't the darkei noyim? Let me see. Shalom. It's not darkei noyim. The chayah darkei noyim of Torah. Whereas Torah's paths are sweet and peaceful. The chassid only meant the original name Shem Arisa, the birth name. But loyal Shem Aschanar, the new name.
That's when Saisa what we just said. What before we just said that it's not a problem. We'll give bracha. It's not a. It's no
he's saying
problem.
It again. He's saying it again.
Yeah. He holds, that's what he holds. Second name is not a problem.
No, but he's saying even if it's the first, the last tshuva says even the first name shouldn't be a problem for that same reason. Well, you just said, because now he has another, it brings bracha to the first name also.
Both directions. He held that it went both directions. Both directions are good. He meant over there, he means in a case where there's no name added. In a case where there's no name added, no name at all added because there was no choyli. Like in most cases, it's a normal situation, there's no choyli involved. The issues that come up is the father-in-law and the son-in-law have the same name,
right.
From birth. That's what that's a normal situation. This situation is not the regular situation.
Isn't another view to give the simple.
Mivad kolzeh, besides for all this, lefi mechtavch, according to your letter, writes the son-in-law, your father-in-law wants the schatin in suman abon. He wants for your sister-in-law, dafka, someone who's a Talmud Chacham. If it's a Talmud Chacham, it's a mitzvah to marry Talmud Chacham. Shoyim mitzvah. It's a someone who tries to keep a mitzvah. He's not going to have anything bad come to him. No evil will befall him. So he's doing a mitzvah. So he's building up a tshuva. He's adding different ideas to add them all up together to build up a case to say that this is permitted. V'timani al roi v'oilon. I'm concerned in most of the world. Shalos bit amaretz for their daughter to marry an amaretz. That's not a big deal. He's not concerned to stop. Chazal didn't approve of that. They didn't hold it was the best thing. What are you guys writing me letters about? You write me a letter that, it's a problem the father and the son are the same. How come on all the people that are not marrying, they're allowing the daughters to marry Ami Oritz, that's not an issue. That's a clear Gemara that says it's not beneficial.
What is
a full clear Torah in Chazal, should not be like a tzava, just tam a tzava.
Why is he saying this to this?
According to my das, yigmer chesencha, your Hashidduch hazeh, your father-in-law should make the shidduch for your sister-in-law. V'yasa ma'ez l'shem shem, everything's migud. The kids, don't bring me tzavois over here, Amarov. Bring me gemaras and poiskim. Don't quote me tzavois with the chassid. It's probably only for his only zeta. And we have here Hashini Hashem. It's a new name. He never spoke about a case where there was a new name.
This is exactly why we needed the Baal Shem Tov.
And it's a mitzvah you're doing. You want to marry Talmud Chacham. Shari mitzvah yeh davar ra. So now you to be Yehuda. Deal with this issue.
There's only one problem now.
Yeah.
Good.
They're writing to him because they don't want the shit to go through.
No. It's a separate situation. No, not in this situation. No. I missed two situations. I mentioned in the middle of Tshuva to Shev Yankiv, another place.
Oh, okay. That's
he didn't want it. Yeah.
That's what you
mean. No, they really wanted it.
You were trying to say if this was the same Shev Yankiv, this whole thing would be vital. The night to be Yehuda would have a whole different gong.
They want the shidduch to go through.
Okay. Mazel tov on the shidduch.
Here.
No, maybe we're afraid.
Two together. Now we're going to go through a tshuva of Tzemach Tzedek on this issue.
That's why she's drawn to the name.
Young man over here.
We're now going to see there's a tshuva of Tzemach Tzedek, the grandson of the Baal Tanya, also deals with this shaila.
You heard him.
But he didn't say
keep these two
me.
Together.
These two together.
Square.
Together.
Yeah.
Shmurik.
You want
to
get one?
Amen.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah.
Anyone else?
Okay. Rabbi Isai. We got him, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, the Tzemach Tzedek over here. The beginning of this thing. We're gonna start reading in the middle in the left column. The left column, it starts im. The first paragraph im. The big letters, the big bold letters im. Im yesh lahakpid. I'm gonna see the second column in yesh lahakpid. Now, until now, the Tzemach Tzedek is in the middle of a discussion about another tzavo. Now what we're gonna read is talking about our situation. But before this, he discussed another tzava, another instruction of Yehuda HaChassid. As what we mentioned earlier, that Yehuda HaChassid writes that a people should not marry his son and daughter into the same family, or his two sons into the same family, to two daughters. That's what Yehuda HaChassid said. Now the Tzemach Tzedek writes about himself, this is in his Piskei Dinim, Sefer Piskei Dinim, Pesukim, that he made a shidduch for his son. He had a son of Yisrael Noach, and made a shidduch of Yisrael Noach with the family, and then he made a shidduch with his daughter with that family. So what was he soymach on? So before this shtickle, he explains what he was soymach on. And part of what he was soymach on, part of the issues that he was soymach on, was that he quotes the Noi Dibi Yehuda, that the Noi Dibi that we just read, that the Noi Dibi Yehuda held that it's only meant for Zarei, for the seed. Furthermore, he brings over there the Tshuva Shev Yankiv that I told you outside. The Shev Yankiv, I only had a very old print, so I didn't bring a copy. It was just only a few lines. The Shev Yankiv says that even if it's a suffix, if the tzavois were only for his seed, and maybe it was for all of Klal Yisrael, still, no, that's enough to make a heter. Just to say that it's lav dafka for all Klal Yisrael, it's enough to make a heter. Yehuda HaChassid went for the kav, it's for Zarei. But he says, even if we don't know for sure for Zarei, maybe that's enough, you add a suffix in, and we see many Rabbanim and Gedolim weren't concerned about mother-in-laws and daughter-in-laws or father-in-laws and sons having the same name, so we don't have to be chayish, but from that situation was a bedieven. They already had made the clothes on the shidduch, made an engagement. That's where he starts off. He actually brings it regarding, he brings these tshuvas of the Noi Dibi Yehuda and Shev Yankiv to discuss his own situation where he married into a family twice, the same family. Now he goes on to the next issue, to the issue we're dealing with, about the names. Daughter-in-laws and mother-in-laws, father-in-laws and son-in-laws. Im yesh lahakbid, does one have to be makbid? Mishma shakas, b'tzavas, yibin yor l'chassid, sim l'chavav, chav zayin, v'sefich sim, z'vay zayin, here he quotes it. Layis, this is the tzava, in the parentheses. Layisa adam isha, sheshma kishem imay. Oishmai kishem chaviv. Vim not nisa, if someone did get married, and they didn't follow this instruction, they didn't know about it. Yishana Hashem, they should make a Shini Hashem, change the name. Ulai Yesh Tikkun, maybe there's hope. Maybe there's hope.
Stop.
So he has a problem over here. There's a the Shem Hakala, the name of the Kala was Musa. Al-Derech Mashal, example. The Ema Chos and the mother of the Chos and the mother-in-law was Musa Hinda. She had two names, Musa Hinda.
My mother's name is Hinda Musa.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah. And she married who? Not Musa,
Mus. And she married
who? The he ain't any crass. Gamla mix a nosha shemechabavad. No, she is not called, the mother-in-law is not called Musa or Hinda for itself. She called both together, Musa Hinda. They call her both together as both means. So what's the halach? This is what he's going to discuss now. Hine, be'ikr dvarav, kasha li mitamad arach. I have a problem b'chlav with this tzavar of the chassid. It's against the clear gemara. Metzina, we find shemeroyim, the meroyim, loyhoyim, akpidim alzeh. They were not makbar in this. Kenis gesham, it's mentioned in gemara soita, shmul sava. Shmuel the elder was Chamua, the father-in-law of the Rav Shmuel. So they both were called Shmuel.
It was called Shmuel Saba.
That was a last name, you know, like a nickname.
No, it was like it was a Torah of Kabbalah.
In the beginning,
right? Rabbi, you know,
in the beginning,
elder.
You get older, Shmuel Saba.
The say they have a Gemara Menaches. The Gemara says Rami Bar Tamri. There was a person named Rami Bar Tamri. Du Chamoy, he was the father-in-law of Rami Bar Dikuli. So the father-in-law and the son-in-law, were name was Rami. Menaches, Soita. Luchura Me'achash HaGemara Muchach Lehafich. If the Gemara clearly, it's obvious, not like the Tzvar of Yehuda Chassid, we shouldn't follow it. V'ayim Etumas Hadash, and see one of the later Rishonim, Shekosav, he writes about a certain thing, Al-Mashakosav Sefer Chassidim, Sefer Chassidim is the other work of Yehuda Chassid. There's a lot of parallels between the two works, Havaz of Yehuda Chassid and the Sefer Chassidim. Sefer Chassidim is much, much bigger. So Havaz of Chassidim is much shorter. It's like about, I don't remember, 80 Tzavoyis, 80 short instructions. Tzavoyis of Yehuda, the Sefer Chassidim of his has maybe 2,000 things, ideas, instructions. Now, Tumas Hadashim writes about something that Rabbi Yehuda Chassid writes in the Sefer Chassidim Neged HaGemara, which is up against our Gemara. The Lekel Mislachalav, you can't be soymech on it. It must be some mistake. Who knows what it is? But we're not going to rely on it if it's clearly against our Gemara. Ayin Bach, Yerdeya, Amnam. So that's step one. Step one is L'chora, it's against the Gemara. Two Gemaras, and we have a Tumas Hadashim which tells us that when the Rabbi Yehuda Chassid went against the Gemara for some reason. Looks like it's against the Gemara. We're not going to follow it. We don't understand it. Something's wrong. We don't understand it. We follow our Gemara. Amman be'emes yishloimer de raya ba Gemara. Shloimer, there's no raya from these Gemaras against the Yehuda Chassid. Yine b'simin tafayin zayin b'fnim kosov asharin yon izvogim shleish mo'im hender. Yehuda Chassid writes in the Sefer Chassidim a number of different marriages which he suggests not to go into these marriages. And he says that very harmful things can happen if you go into these marriages. Sheesh noyim hem. Kein ingin hashar v'tzorich rachim gdoilim lafich hashar min yoni akan l'shoni. He says, someone who doesn't listen to me, doesn't listen to these instructions, and goes into these type of marriages, he needs rachim gdoilim. Great mercy. That he shouldn't be affected by it. Im kein, his soul says, the Tzemach Tzedek, yesh loyimar, that it's not a contradiction to the Gemara, we're not going to be able to disregard Yehuda Chassid's words. Why is it not a contradiction? The same thing that he writes about another issue, you need rachim gedolim if you do it. Same thing over here on our issue. You can go do it. You can marry someone with the same mother-in-law and the same daughter-in-law. It's okay. However, you're going to need rachim gedolim, great mercy. So if you're a big tzaddik, you have great mercy. You'll get great mercy. You have big schusim. So Hashem's going to take care of you. Nothing's going to be a problem. If you don't have it, the Rachim Gdolim is not issue. The Chachamim in Gemara, the Meiroim, the Gemara Menaches, the two Ramis, or the Gemara in Sait, the two Shmuels, they are big tzaddikim, big Chachamim. So they needed Rachim Gdolim to make such a marriage. They had Rachim Gdolim. They had big Schusim.
It's supposed to be Saimech, had Schusim and Rachim Gdolim?
They were able to be Saimech. They were big tzaddikim.
Yaakov Avinu. They didn't have this Kabbalah.
Wait, one minute. We're going to bring a Raya. We have a Raya. We have a Raya from a Gemara that you Saimech had Schusim. One minute.
They didn't have this Kabbalah. Who says they had to be Saimech had Schusim? They didn't even know about this Takana.
It's not a later takana. He's saying it's unhealthy. If you do this in the marriage, someone's going to be nifter in the marriage.
Who said they even Rami and Bami? Who knows? Who said they even knew about?
If Rabbi Yehuda Chassid knew, say something.
Yes, how come that no one else made this takana if he knew?
And they didn't have to.
Only he knew. Maybe for his door, he had a neshama for that door to say.
Okay, Ishloimer. Halachinam Yavila. The fiach ain't lo biraim and meroyim. Can't bring a raya from meroyim against Rabbi Yehuda Chassid. The nefishis chusayu. They had a lot of schusim. You talk them, they were sure themselves. Shaliyazaklam. It's not gonna damage them if they go against. They knew it's not they're going against the Yehuda Chassid.
Right, this whole concept.
Not the shot that they're going against the Chassid is not problematic. Right. They also know but Ruchnius has problems. Right. They know that Ruchnius has problems. He's saying a fact, I can see there's issues. You do this, it's dangerous. Spiritually this is dangerous for you. It's spiritually dangerous, it's gonna affect you physically, Chas v'Shalom. But these are my Rami, we're not concerned. We have a lot of schosim, they're going to protect us. You have schosim, we'll protect you.
You're sure.
You know? Oh, Gdoyel Mizu, I'll show you a greater Gemara. I'll show you a Gemara. We see clearly that schosim, you can rely on schosim. There's a Gemara in Chulin that says about Rav Chanina that there was one of the Mechashvis, one of the witches, wanted to take some dirt from underneath his feet, from underneath his shoes, so she could do witchcraft on this dirt. And therefore, do bad things to him, be able to affect him. Now, Rabbi Yehuda, Rabbi Chanina said, you can take all the dirt you want. Why? Ein ein mavade, afilu bikshofim. Hashem is everywhere. Ein ein mavade. There's no place where Hashem is not, even in kshofim and kishuf. So I'm going to be protected. Now, not every person should go running around doing, telling witches, you can do whatever you want with my dirt.
It has to be very high.
You have to be careful. Rav Chanina, was Saimich. He lived on that level, where Hashem was with him all the time. So good, he was Saimich on it. You know, we say Yosef was punished because he asked the Sar Hamashkim a favor that Paris should take. Shemem, what was the big deal? Yosef's Madrega, that was considered a loss of bitachin.
Right.
Even that was not something he should have done. He should have mamish relied on the Eibishter totally. For us, that's wrong. If we have a way to get out and you don't take it, it's an Aveira. But for Yosef's Madrega, so for Tzaddikim, it's different. So therefore, it's not a Raya that it's against the Gemara. No, it's not against the Gemara, and therefore we still have to be concerned with Yehuda Chassid because we're not those Tzaddikim. So how can we do this marriage over here of a Musa with a Musa Hinda?
Right,
he was
not to give
him. He didn't want to be son of a sikis. Now, v'shut Shev Yankiv, and the Shuvah Shev Yankiv is the Mechav Gimel, we mentioned that before about Peh. He says, like, you downplays it, you don't have to be concerned with the chassid. You're not necessarily from his era of his. We see people were makbin on this tzava, this specific instruction. Our mothers and daughters, we see many Rabbanim and Gedolim, we're not concerned. So Shev Yankiv doesn't feel that we should be concerned with it. However, Doidi Zikni. Hagoyin of Yehuda Leib, my great uncle, Zechayin of Avraham, my great uncle, the Maril, the brother of the Alter Rebbe, the Balatanya. Amarli Mishem Abeinu Hagoyin Zalashma Seid and Siya. He told me the name of his brother, the Alter Rebbe. Shehik Bibi Yoisa, that he was concerned with this thing. The Shev Yankiv, a big pasuk, said he's not concerned with this specific tzavar of Yehuda Chassid. However, my uncle, my great uncle, told me the name of my Zayda, the Alter Rebbe, that he was concerned, he was makbid about this. Shalayi Hashem Hakala Kashem Chamoisa. Even more, he was even more concerned for that combination, that a combination Yoisim al Shmoy Kashem Chamit. He was more concerned with daughter-in-laws having the same name as a mother-in-law than son-in-laws having the same name as a father-in-law. Why?
Really,
why was he very concerned about it, Alter Rebbe?
The Mishal in the dark.
Why? Shem Shezeh Nizbar B'Mishach Sinim. There is a Sefer Kabbalah one of the Talmidim Arizal, one of the from the school of Arizal called the Mishal Chassidim. The Mishal Chassidim is a Kabbalah Sefer, and he brings down much later period of time, not from the Rishonim, from the Arizal, after the Arizal. The Mishal Chassidim quotes this idea that Api Kabbalah, not because of Rabbi Yehuda HaChassid, he quotes on his own Api Kabbalah, a father-in-law, a mother-in-law, and a daughter-in-law should not have the same name. Hamishal Chassidim lehetik rakdiv Arizal. And the Baal HaTanya said that the Mishal Chassidim only wrote what he heard from the Arizal. And this Sefer, the Mishal Chassidim, he was just quoting things from the Arizal. The Arizal, we accept what the Arizal says. Klal Yisrael tries as much as they could to follow what the Arizal says. It came, Estama Raza Bekisa, most probably the Mishal Chassidim writes this in a work which he brings only the Arizal's Torah. He was probably saw this from the Arizal. Therefore, the Alter Rebbe, my Zayde, said my great uncle, was very makbid on this specific tzava. But Amar Huzal Shul Sakana. The Alter Rebbe said it's a sakana to go into this, that a mother-in-law, daughter-in-law should have the same name. Don't go into such a shidduch. So how am I going to deal with this as a Semot Tzedek? I have a question over here. I have a daughter-in-law named Musa, and the prospective daughter-in-law, and the prospective mother-in-law's name is Musa Hinda. And my Zayda says this is a serious thing. It's not only, if it was only at Tzavah Sabir al-Chassid, okay, I have an Oidi Bihuda, so you're not the Zer, it's not a problem. I have a Shev Yankiv who says, in this specific Tzavah, many Gedoilim weren't concerned for it. But what should I do, said the Tzavah Tzedek? My Zayda said it's a Sakona, and it's not only brought from Yudah Chassid, it's brought in Kabbalah from the Mishal Siddim, who only quotes things from that Rizal. We are considered words of the Rizal. So what are we going to do with this? So Tzavah Tzedek has his own mahalich, how to be matter.
Isn't it also the very
two names? Right, there's two names.
There's two name things.
Not the
changing,
same name.
But that's how we do it nowadays. This one has one name.
We have to go to Ma'ariv. So let's read a few more lines. Let's skip the parentheses. Afal Pikein, he says, even so, that my Zayde was very makbid, I'm going to still be matter. Literally, in this case, the Menidin Dan Ein Lochush Klal. She'ein Shmisein Shavin. It's not like they have exact same name. But this is the whenever we quote this psak, it's a Tzemach Tzedek's psak. So the Tzemach Tzedek's Kiddush. Everyone around the table is quoting as Pashit. We're actually learning the source of this first one who gave the psak. It's a Tzemach Tzedek. Menach Zanan. Let's see, said the Tzemach Tzedek. When it comes to writing a get, and writing a get is very important to make sure you write the exact name of the husband and the wife. It has to be exact. Mm-hmm. How it's to be written exactly, the way the name is written, the sound, all the names.
The country, the city, everything.
In Kosov Alzu Shenik Vishnei Shemus, if a woman was called by two names, but when the get was written, by some reason the Rav didn't realize, and he only wrote one name. Kosov, in the get, he wrote Rak Shemechot. The husband is the man is divorcing only one name. He didn't write both names. Vade haget batal midiraisa min haTorah. The get is bottles nothing. Means that one name is not.
Is not enough.
Is not a name. That's not your name. Your name is two names.
So somebody has two names and you call them half a name. One name is half a name. It's not a name.
Im kain, ein al shem echa mishmeisar rak in chatzi hashem. Every when a person has two names. When a person has two names, their two names are not two separate names. People generally like to view their names. I have two names. If you have two names, it really became one name. Now you have two parts of one name. And if the get has only one of those names, it's not pshat we know who you are. It's actually you only wrote half of your name. Half of your name. And therefore the get is not a get. So the Tzemach Tzedek over here, where Musa, one name is Musa, the other is Musa Hinda. Musa is not Musa Hinda, and Musa Hinda is not Musa. It's different names.
Right.
Different name, because Musa Hinda is not Musa and Hinda. Musa Hinda becomes one name. Becomes one name of Musa Hinda.
It's my great grandma.
Musa Hinda? Mus.
Hinda Mus.
Mus's name is Hinda Leva Mus.
No, but before married.
Now he goes on to say, Hain Emes. He gets converses Kamoy Don and Daniel. Don and Daniel. Daniel and Daniel starts with Dal and Nun. It's a different name, Daniel and Don.
It's after two different
That's right. True, by the way. He said if everyone would only call her by one name, and if they, everyone would only call her by one of the names, Yaf Shalaim would be possible to say that that is her name. Because this, since everyone considers that her name, and they forgot it, they sort of like, don't talk about the other name. Everyone calls her only one name. To have a shema, come look at Bixash and Hashem. People consider that her name. Hilgahayim is a mock Moshashim Akpidim. There would be concern for someone who's concerned about this Tavar of Yehuda Chassid that if that's if the only one name was used, then it would be an issue. Vashayin can in this case, Kulam Kurdis of Vashayin Shem is Yachad. They call her both names together, Musa Hinda. That's her name, Musa Hinda. So if they would only call her Musa, even if she had two names from birth, but people only called her Musa, maybe there could be an issue. It's not sure. Maybe there would be an issue in that case where that kilo was her name, because she's always called Musa. But in this case, her name, she's always called Musa Hinda, for sure. Her, that's her name, Musa Hinda together. Now, Lamaisa, by the way, I want to add one more thing. We're not going to read the whole thing, but he says one more point he brings out. You know, by Shini Hashem, we add, what's the point why we change someone's name? Someone's a choyler.
Name is Shana Mazel.
We change the name Shana Mazel. Ask the someone tzaddik, how does that help? How does that help to revoke the Gzar Din that's on this person? He still has the original name. If the original name was a cause for concern.
Take it off.
That was a cause for concern. We would have to tell him to take it off.
You answered it.
How can we don't tell him to take it off? And we tell him you can keep the original name.
You can add a name.
That's another raya. It's another raya. I have a raya from Gittin. And then I have a raya from the Minig. That if we want to change the Gzar Din, we want to say he's called, he's a new name, a new person. And the Gzar Din's going to go, he's going to change his mazel. We add a name and that becomes the two names together. Become a new name.
New name, exactly.
A new name. Now, this lashtik, I can't leave out the lashtik of Maimonides. He says a gevaldike shtickle. He b'chalal explains that all these api kabbalah. What is the issue? He goes off the tangent. Now that he finishes heter, so Masevik says like this: what is b'chalal the reasoning for Yehuda Chassid that all these different marriages are problematic? What are all these issues of these marriages? We don't understand why. All the poskim are trying to understand, and each one gives their own reasons, and based on their reasons, make different heterim. But what is the reason over here? So Masadik, I feel a pikabala. This is the issue. And I'm going to base on something I heard from my Rebbe, from the my Zayde, the Balatanya. What's the whole issue of by Issa HaRoyis in the Torah, by forbidden relationships in the Torah? The Torah uses a very strange language. It says, Ervas Imcha Loisagala. Isha Imba Bita Loisagala. So the word Loisagala, don't reveal. What's a Sagala? Say, don't marry. Don't have relations with. What is Lay Sigala? What's Lay Sigala? What's Lay Sigala? What's the Gilui? He said like this. All these marriage relationships that we don't go into, all that Royas of the Torah, this is the Alter Rebbe about that Royas.
Yeah.
Is because really, Lamaila, these are the way things work in the Sviris. In the Sviris, this is the Arayas are permitted. Arayas are big Soydas of Halacha. Lamaila, brothers and sisters, do come together in Ruchnius Dikir. For example, this is Kabbalah a little bit, Sviris, the Midis and Malchus, called Zah and Malchus,
right,
are considered Zachar and Nekeva. They're considered, there's a marriage of the Sviris. Those Sviris, the marriage of the three, they're also called brother and sister. How could brother and sister get married? This is Saidis, Lamaila, all the Nyanam of Aroyes are very high concepts, very high spiritual Kabbalistic concepts. And Lamaila, there's no issue with these things. Adra, but that's the way it works, Lamaila. But when it comes into this world, you can't do these things in this world. That's what it says, Loisigala. You're not allowed to reveal these secrets, these Kabbalistic secrets are not in this world. It's meant for the world of Atzilus, high up in the Olam Yisrael, in the higher world. In this Olam Atachtin, you're like revealing the secrets of the king in the streets. If someone goes and says secrets. We all know everyone's talking about different secrets, where this one said this secret, and then he revealed this intelligence report and that report.
What's the big deal? You're not allowed to reveal the secret. So if the king has a private secret, it's a very special thing, and someone goes in the streets and tells everyone about it, it's a terrible thing. So someone goes and does arayis, the forbidden relationships, which lamayla, these are deep Kabbalistic secrets. He does this down here in this world. He's like revealing the secrets of the king. Loi segala, you're not allowed to reveal it. The lashon in the Torah is gili. That's why the Torah is loi segala. You're not allowed to reveal these secrets down in this world. Arayis down here are aser, and lamayla it's a big mitzvah. Therefore, this is a beer that the Alter Rebbe told his enukol, the Tzemach Tzedek, about why these relationships in the Torah are forbidden, why they're called loi segala. However, the Tzemach Tzedek applies this concept to our situation. The concepts of having mother-in-law and daughter-in-law with the same name, Lamaila is not an issue.
It's like incest.
Lamaila is fine, Lamaila. He brings out in Sfira Salsa how mother-in-laws and daughter-in-laws can have the same name. It's not an issue. Bina and Malchus can have the same name.
They could get along too.
And not an issue. But if someone does that down here.
It's a big mother.
I know a case that shows exactly why.
By the way, there's also a tshuva somewhere that's Tzemach Tzedek. We don't have time. But there's also a tshuva that's Tzemach Tzedek, same thing. And it's just this is a little bit of the Tzavas of Yilach Chassid.
I
have two partners. It's the most practical thing.
I married two partners.
You also have it.
And my wife named the same like my mother name.
Only one name?
No, my mother has two names.
And they call her both names?
My mother, they call both names.
Okay. My mother,
so that's the way you dealt with that issue. With the other issue, you don't live near the same city.
That's coming for the marriage, so what could be better
than that? Exactly.
It's her mother-in-law.
But you have to remember that Rabbi Yehuda Chassid, you know there are certain people who know that they're the grandchildren of Rabbi Yehuda Chassid. It's not to be Yehuda, the children of Yehuda and the Shariyaki won't help them because they know they're from the family of Yehuda Chassid.
What's going on? This
Heter, there are people today that know the trace of back, so it won't help them. What the Lady Behold and Shemian can say that, oh, you're not the family. They say they are the family. So for them, you have to look for the